Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of British telco holding firm BT after India's Bharti Enterprises said it would acquire a 24.5% stake in the company to buy out its top investor, Patrick Drahi. BT shares rose 6%. Also in focus, shares of KeyCorp following a minority investment by the Bank of Nova Scotia. KeyCorp shares jumped 13% in pre-market trading. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Barrick Gold after it reported better-than-expected second-quarter results. Now, this sent the stock higher by 2.5%. The Organization of the Petroleum Exporting Countries, or OPEC, cuts its forecast for global oil demand growth in 2024. OPEC, in a monthly report, said world oil demand will rise by 2.11 billion barrels per day this year, down from the 2.25 billion expected last month. The group cites weaker-than-expected data in the first half of the year and softer expectations for China. This is the first reduction in OPEC's 2024 forecast since it was first made in July 2023. In the report, OPEC also cut next year's demand growth estimate to 1.78 million barrels per day from the 1.85 million previously expected. Global oil prices, though, remained steady after the report was released. Asian markets ended Monday trade on a mixed note as investors looked ahead to key U.S. and China data. Beijing set to release retail sales and industrial production numbers on Thursday, which are expected to show Asia's biggest economy continues to underperform. Chinese shares saw muted trade. Here at home, Philippine shares kicked off the week on the back foot ahead of the BSP's policy decision.
My baseline expectation is no cut. But given the recent decline in inflation and particularly core inflation, it opens the window for at least a 25 basis point cut. Now, the question is, will they do it earlier than the Fed? Over the past week, we've seen the governor, highlighting it. So most likely they could cut by Thursday. There's this market adage, buy the rumor, sell the fact. And probably that's the reason why the market has already taken profits from last week or has retreated, mainly because I guess two things. One is on August 14, people are waiting what inflation in the U.S. will probably be. Will it be at 3% or lower?
Yeah.
Now, the other one is, will the BSP cut? So, but the more important date is August 24, when the Fed and the rest of the central bankers meet for at the Jackson Hole meeting. Okay. So that's something we'll probably get clues whether the Fed will probably cut rates in September or probably in December.
In notable stock movements in the region, Adani Group companies lost as much as $19 billion in market value on Monday before recovering some of the losses. That's after new allegations from U.S. short seller Hindenburg Research. This time, it's accusing the head of India's market regulator of having links to offshore funds also used by the Adani Group.